Most of us, when we were kids and listened to the radio, grew up on the radio, we used to think there was a little studio inside the radio. Mm-hmm. I remember I used to lie there with the glow of the thing by my bedside table and try to imagine all those little people in there, what they, you know, the little studios. And in a sense, the record allows us to do that because you create this world in a little, a tiny little place with pieces of tape and microphones. It really isn't at all like what it sounds like.
Take him away for grooving.
Spot for the best in food, fun, and dancing proudly presents the fastest rise in interim governmental administration in the Western Hemisphere, the Cabinet of the United States of Beef. From Rochester, New York, on lead guitar, the Secretary of Peace. On drums, the Secretary of Inner Self. On saxophone, the Secretary of States of Consciousness. And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, the expert, the most high chief of the United States of Being, Stark Van Coolen.
Yes, we do. On this birthday, the founder of our tribe, Sodom Clinton Power, the first to take our sacred oath. If elected, I refuse to serve. Pow! I come to present for you hippification, the first treaty of world peace. Some of you cats may recall the old days of the brown shoe, when there was war and fight and soldier.
Yes, those were ungroovy times.
Well, now.
We weren't going any more out on the line with our humor than other people who were working to see our society renovate itself during that period. There was danger. Yeah, we felt a danger. You know, there were a lot of guys and gals out on the street, and there were people in Nam. And
we were trying to show, or we hoped to, by the work we were doing, show ourselves and show the rest of the people in the new culture what things looked like. I don't think that we were really in danger, because we were only revealing what was truly around us, at least from our point of view. And it seemed to reach the proper kind of response from the audience.
People saw us as a touchstone of the revolution. We didn't pretend to be that. That wasn't our exoskeleton didn't read, "We are the revolution." We didn't go around doing that. But they saw us as that, and our surrealism and our politics and our social consciousness excited them to that.
How sweet it is. Hey, Secretary of Peace, baby, what are we putting down in Nigeria?
Major Hit is on the screen now with the Daily Upfront Report.
Ciao, baby. This is Major Hit in the cockpit of the Enola McLuhan, flagship of the 7th Airborne Peace Corps and Lending Library. We're now over the center of rebel resistance in northern Nigeria and preparing to drop literature.
Do the Bombay door thing. Bombay door swinging and open, baby. Ruby and out. Bombardier, it's your karma.
We're almost ready to drop it. I can see the entire rebel force running out of their huts, looking up at the sky.
7, 14, 11, 16, target ready. Hucks away!
There they go. The literature is in a tight pattern. The rebels are beginning to scatter, but it's too late. On target! God, this is an awesome moment. The last stronghold of unhip resistance is out of sight. Under 8 million hardbound copies of The Naked Lunch, it's all over. We're coming home.
The electrician concept was like, where does power come from? Where does the power come from to enable a government to rule a people? You know, where does power, electoral power, see, electrical and electoral power, where does it come from? It comes from the willingness of the people to allow themselves to be governed. All right? So basically, the electrician figure represented that corruption of power, the madness of power. People being empowered by certain people, individuals who are of an authoritarian nature, who like to rule and like to control and like to be powerful, enabled by the people to get away with it, to do it. And many of them go mad. And that was, you know, that's the genesis of the power mad electrician. He wanted more energy, more power, you know, and was willing to do anything to get it. And it's a metaphor really for the oil industry, the rapacious behavior of capitalists and all the rest of it. If you take your power into your own hands, then you become the electrician. And waiting for the electrician or someone like him was the idea of who is going to empower you to live your own life the way you want to live it. And how can you best accomplish that?
Oh, this guy's shoveling with two hands.